Hello and welcome to my reaction to the fourth episode of Scrap Princess. It's a bit hard to say. Scrapped Princess. Yeah, I don't know. It doesn't roll off the tongue for me. But much doesn't roll off the tongue for me. So, last episode, they made it to a town. Assassin after them, the guy that we met in episode 1. Plus two new characters. They met a girl who is nice. I don't remember her name. They all have weird name, that's one thing. Let me look. Winya. Yeah, she got captured by the assassin. Shannon, the main guy, is going after her. Pacifia and Raquel. Raquel, I don't know how you pronounce it, I'll need to listen. Raquel and Pacifia, Pacifica, I'll get it right, don't worry, are staying behind. Alright, enough recapping shit. Yeah. Scrap Princess, episode 4. Let's get into this in 3, 2, 1. Genuinely really enjoyed what I saw this morning, the three first episodes. I wouldn't say I'm extremely attached to the character yet, but I really like the adventure they're on, if anything. Really love this opening. Oh yeah, and that revealed to her. Concerto of Encounter and Departure. Hackwell. Oh. Supicun. Okay, that thing. The rules of magic seems to be quite loose. She can do everything. Like levitation, elemental magic, illusion magic. I mean, nothing would happen to her. Okay. Getting him some characterization earlier than I would expect. Not a bad thing. A lone warrior coming in the distance. Best in moonlight. Let's see. Why? Oh. That's what it seems here. Yeah, he wouldn't just turn his back for nothing. He seemed to be a competent warrior. Yeah, I'm not shocked by that. That's a satisfying reason enough for them not to kill. I'll accept it. Okay. Clearly. Well, I mean, you don't need to tell her that she can go. Easier than I was expecting. Okay. Is it the Oracle or something? Okay. Okay. Will she be mean because she knows that Pacifica is the Scrape Princess? Maybe she's gonna be smart and not believe in some dumb prophecy. actually care. Oh. Okay. I'm a bit uncertain now if she's actually going to come with them on the journey. This guy has no idea anything happened. Okay. Your file or something? Perjurers. The whole city. Talk. Speak up. Come on. Really? Okay. Really? I'm surprised. Was it that good? Or is it taste deaf or something? But didn't they just say that they're going to observe them now? Again? Oh, okay. They weren't informed yet. They're really destroying the city? What sense does that make? I'm actually confused about that. Have you ever seen this old horror movie from the like 70s maybe? Or the 80s, I'm not sure, called The Blob. I think that's how it's called. Oh, okay. I guess they knew she would come back to try to save. To help, and yeah, that make it easy to trap her. Oh shit, Evanim. Holy shit. I wasn't expecting that. They might manage to break out of it for a reason. Or maybe windier. Oh shit. Or maybe she actually has power. That was kind of like a Conqueror Aki moment from One Piece. So that was a positive power. Okay, the villain is got the same type of armor as Muvluv. The weight goes up to the jaw like that. Don't know which one came first. I don't remember how old Muvluv is alternative. But who cares? There might be something else that came first that I don't know about. Maybe she has the power to destroy it. Oh, yeah, okay. Did it work? Staff of Destruction. He's a very, how to say, cookie cutter cliche villain so far. He's laughably evil, you know? Hopefully that changes at some point. your master. Yeah, no, she has no point but to run. I mean, they were going to go anyway, but still. Okay, it's your chance. Winia. So she's not coming, okay. Good. I guess I just misunderstood seeing her in the ending. I assume she was with the party, but nope. It's only them three. And I guess the night guy. Oh, shame, she was cute. Once again, he missed everything. I'll definitely get more complicated, I'm sure. Okay, I knew this would come into play at some point when they mentioned that they were twin. Alright. I mean, I don't think I really need to point it out if you've seen a decent amount of anime, of show, of story, of fantasy show. This is like, everything is a cliche to the extreme in this show, but as I said before, it's not... It doesn't bother me. Well, as I said once again, one of my favorite is Lodos, which is the most cliched, even more than this, the most basic. And that's fine. It is true that in this day where the last, like, I guess, I would say 10 years, Sword Art Online came out in 2012. And since Sword Art Online, there has been like this insane wave of isekai fantasy rather than regular fantasy. The regular fantasy genre kind of died. I mean, there was a couple of shows, but when each season you have a couple of isekai fantasy show, it's like, yeah, the classic fantasy kind of died down. So this is a good refresher, you know. It's always fun to go back to see some more classic show. Personally, I really don't have any problem. And yeah, the villains seem pretty shit so far, I would say. Pretty basic. Hopefully it gets better. Okay, not wishing for you. Hopefully it gets better, but I don't think it's gonna kill my enjoyment or anything. To me, I don't expect this to become like my favorite show of all time or anything of the sort, but this would be a fun journey. That's how I'm seeing this show. Anyway, for now, thanks for watching. See you in the next one.